A portion of this video has been sponsored by LastPass. Oh, yeah.
That's stupid.
Hey guys, I'm the Hacksmith, and this is Make It Real. About a year ago, my team and I set out to make the world's heaviest Thor's hammer. We took a replica Mjolnir that we bought from the armor factory and we filled it with molten lead. It weighed in at 73 pounds, which we thought was the heaviest replica Thor's hammer in the world. But another YouTuber called BrainFoo managed to make a slightly larger one filled with lead that weighed in at 91 pounds. Regardless, ours was pretty awesome and made destroying things super fun. But it's not the heaviest, at least not technically. The only option to make a replica hammer heavier is to use a material that has a higher density than lead, which has a density of 11.34 centimeters cubed. That material is tungsten, which has a density of 19.3 grams per centimeter cubed. That's almost 1.5 times as dense. But it's super expensive. Pure tungsten could run over $10,000 in the quantity we need. Luckily, the video went super viral, and it's actually one of our most viewed videos on the channel. So we can justify spending thousands of dollars on some scrap tungsten to try making the world's heaviest Thor's hammer. Plus, we're actually making this as a gift for someone very special, the world's strongest man. You might know him as the Mountain from Game of Thrones. Icelandic-born half-orc Julius Bjornsson. Is that right? Has taken the world's strongest man title years in a row. He can deadlift over 1,000 pounds, bench press over 500, and even throw a washing machine 4 meters. We believe, or rather hope, he'll be able to wield Mjolnir one-handed, just like Thor. After all, his nickname is literally Thor. It's no easy task, though, because it's terribly unbalanced. It requires tremendous wrist strength that perhaps only Thor would possess. Our goal is to make the hammer approximately 50 kilograms, or around 110 pounds. Lifting it would be the equivalent of taking a 100-kilo dumbbell, raising it over your head, and chopping one side off. In fact, there's a great video on BrainFoo's channel showing bodybuilders attempting to lift his 91-pound hammer, and no one could hold it with one hand properly. Well, enough talking about it, let's get started. But first, this section of the video has been sponsored by LastPass. I don't know about you guys, but I hate passwords. We have so many online accounts these days, and they all need a password. I constantly forget mine and have to reset them. It's really, really freaking annoying. Which is why I'm super stoked about this video's sponsor, LastPass. It automates filling out your usernames and passwords for you, so you don't have to. It lets you keep track of your passwords easily without having to write them down or even remember them. Put your passwords on autopilot with LastPass and the Password Vault. Plus, it works on mobile too and autofills your credentials on both mobile sites and apps for both iOS and Android. It makes logging in an absolute breeze. It comes with unlimited password storage and free cross-device sync. And it's super secure. The Password Vault uses AES 256-bit encryption, which is done at a device level. That means the data stored in the Password Vault is kept secret, even from LastPass. It protects your data at every step and gives you the power to make your passwords
impenetrable.
Plus, with LastPass, it makes sharing passwords safe, secure, and easy. We use LastPass Business, which allows me to control which employees have access to which accounts, which, as you can imagine, is super helpful for running a business. Click the link below to learn more about LastPass today. Thanks again to LastPass for sponsoring this part of the video. All right, is the modified hammer ready?
Oh yeah.
Sweet. So, let's just open it up again, and then we can make it the world's... And the general plan is we're going to put pieces of as much tungsten as we can fit inside the hammer, And then we're going to melt down lead to fill in all the extra space. And the goal is to make this thing weigh over 100 pounds, ideally heavier than Stormbreaker.
Yes. So right now it weighs 10 pounds. So we need to add 90 pounds of tungsten and lead. Tungsten lead soup.
So one of our subscribers actually sold us the scrap tungsten, and that is his packaging job. I got a better idea. We've got the stunt wire system. Let's lift it up to the ceiling and then drop it.
Go.
Wow. Should we up the ante and light it on fire while we're doing this? So we have to do this quickly before the fire catches onto the Kevlar holding it up. Drop. Yeah! And that's how you open a box. All right, so we've got our chunks of tungsten now. Just this small piece weighs almost 20 pounds, 42.7.
Error.
Just over 85 pounds. If we can get these two big pieces and one lead, we should be able to break 100 pounds. We're gonna wanna fill this piece to the brim with lead.
To the bandsaw.
So how the bandsaw works away on that piece of tungsten, I think we should probably do it the old-fashioned way, by hand. Just a sliver. All right, 1 millimeter. Is that doing anything? That took about a week of cutting to get all this tungsten chopped up. We went through, I think, 7 or 8 bandsaw blades. Tungsten is extremely hard to cut, machine. Basically, you're not supposed to. Tungsten is usually what's used to do the cutting, like tungsten carbide bits and all kinds of stuff like that.
Puzzle time.
Start at the top.
Feeling how heavy those are?
I don't know how lead's gonna get into all those little gaps. I feel like it's not gonna work nearly as well as we hope it will. We can cut back to the scene when it doesn't work.
Cool.
Right there.
Perfect.
We did it!
Oh, heavy.
74.5 pounds. So already, just the base of the hammer weighs as much as our lead fill nail there. 74.5 plus 15.5, so we're up to 90 pounds. The handle on this piece, 92.5 pounds.
So if we can get one of these, we get 102.5.
All right, so you might be wondering, how are we gonna melt down this lead? We're gonna use a lightsaber. All right, that was freaking awesome. But I think we should probably just use the stove.
And a flamethrower.
And what better way to melt lead than with not a flamethrower?
To the back.
So to ensure consistent heat throughout the Thor hammer, we're actually heating up the PUBG bulletproof frying pan. And hypothetically, the lead should just melt real nice into all the cracks.
Starting to melt yet?
This is our boring flamethrower. So as you can see, it's a bit more violent.
Oh. Dave.
Dave.
This is our 22.7 pounds. Even with just the top of the lead, we're up to 22.7 pounds. Plus about 75 pounds, which means we're almost at 100 pounds. Oh no, no, no! The bottom cap of the Thor hammer separated, and now it's leaking molten lead through the metal dust, so we have an extra hammer. We're gonna have like 125, 130 pounds.
Damn it. We can cut back to the scene when it doesn't work.
the first melting of lead into the Thor's hammer didn't go so well, and it kind of dumped lead everywhere and destroyed this hammer. So, to make this not happen with the next hammer, which is the last one that we have, we are going to intentionally melt this one to figure out what the melting point is to prevent this from happening again.
Because we were heating up the Thor hammer on a propane burner, we weren't actually able to control the temperature. So we actually got it probably hotter than the melting point of lead and the actual hammer itself. So what we're gonna do this time is we've actually gone and we've bought a stove for 20 bucks off Craigslist. And that means we're gonna be able to preheat the entire thing to around 500 Fahrenheit, which is still well below the melting point of lead, which is around 625 Fahrenheit. So hopefully we can get this hot enough that when we pour the liquid lead in, it flows, fills all the gaps, and doesn't melt the outside. But who knows what will actually happen. Either way, let's get started. Okay, so the general idea here is we've got a nice big cast iron frying pan. Now what we're going to do is we're going to surround it with iron filings. This way we can get a consistent heat mass around it. Pick it. That's heavy. To the oven. I don't think any of us possess the strength to just go and slide it in. So we've actually set up a chain hoist from the ceiling and we'll actually be lifting it up. Let's get this frying pan in there. Time to start cooking. You need to melt down some lead. Now that the hammer is hopefully up to about 500 Fahrenheit. All right, so we actually got a thermal camera, which you can come see right here. All right, let's turn the burner on. Ooh, that heats up real fast. All right, let's throw the lead on. You can literally see the heat starting to seep through the pan. It looks like the lead is around 70 degrees Celsius at the moment. This is a lot easier than what we were doing before. Whoa.
Fire. And it's pretty molten now.
So what we have to do here is quickly remove the hammer, place it onto this concrete over here, and then hopefully we're going to be able to just pour all that lead in and let it cool down. Oh yeah! Look at that.
So we probably put 15 pounds in.
Okay, we got to cool this down. Did someone say they were the Hacksmith's biggest fan? £91.2, 114 pounds exactly, 51.7 kilos. As far as I know, that is the heaviest Thor's hammer. There were two little bubbles formed on the outside here and here. We're hopefully gonna be able to sand them down like a Charmian. Sand her up. Oh yeah, look at that.
Is that good?
Oh my god! Now all we have to do is polish up the hammers, put the leather back on the handle, and I think we'll call it a day.
And then we're gonna use thread locker to make sure that it does not come apart. There can be some very strong people trying to swing this around.
All right, now to make this hammer truly unique for Thor, we're also going to engrave an inscription on it, which is no easy task. We're going to have to somehow load this into the CNC machine.
That was difficult. I think it's heavy enough, but I'm going to clamp it down just in case.
Is this going to be able to move it?
I think so.
You tried jogging?
We're going to be using this new engraver that we got from Tormach. It's a spring-loaded tungsten tip, and we drag it along and it scratches in the engravement.
Whosoever holds this hammer, if he be worthy, shall possess the power of Hathor.
Alright, we're done. We've created the world's heaviest 1-to-1 scale replica Mjolnir filled with tungsten. We've got our regular replica, which weighs about 10 pounds. We've got our lead-filled one, which weighs 73 pounds. Let's see how much the tungsten one weighs. 114.4 pounds. That's over 50 kilograms. Now, that might actually be a bit hard for you guys to imagine, so we're gonna bring out some actual Olympic weights to show you what that actually weighs. This is the same as this. You'd actually have to add an entire, another 45 pound plate to get to the same weight as this. Riley?
Oh my god! Ha! Ouch.
Perfect. Tungsten has a density almost four times as much as steel. Which is insane. Let's see who's heavier, Jordy or Thor's hammer. 3, 2, 1. We're gonna have each team member here at Hacksmith try and pick up each of these hammers to see if they're worthy, and if so, at which level of Thor are they? 1, 2, 3.
Level one.
The first one.
Easy.
Level two.
Okay. Easy. Will that one feel light now?
I know.
Nice.
Okay.
If you drop it, you're fired.
Yeah.
Oh my god. That is so unreasonable.
Oh, I'm dizzy. I can't get it above, like, here.
It's falling. Oh.
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 Uh-oh. No, that's not as good.
Oh, boy! Ammonium nitride. Thanks, Chujimufu. Oh! Oh! Ah! Ah! Oh! Oh, this fell over. Oh boy, that was close. I made that way farther than I thought I would. I need more. Oh yeah. Okay, if I got that far, the mountain can definitely do it. Where do I go from here? Alright, that's the video. Make sure you're subscribed because you are not going to want to miss it when we take this to Iceland to give to Thor himself. So make sure you're subscribed, hit that notification bell, and don't forget to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching.
Oh no!
Dave!
Dave!
Thanks.